In this video, you learn all you need to know about getting livestock data from the internet to Excel. So first, we'll look at how to add and analyze the stock data. Then we'll build a simple stock portfolio. And finally, we'll compare our investments visually. Let's get into it. First, let's learn to add and analyze real stock data. So over here in this Excel file, you can see that we have the stocks on our watch list, meaning those that maybe we're considering buying. And next to them, we have the ticker, which is basically the trading name for the company, alongside some other features that we would like to have in order to make a better analysis. So for these, you can actually go and get them from the internet, but that's a bit tedious, and Excel does have a built-in solution. For it, we're just gonna select all of the tickers, so Control Shift down here. Then we're gonna go towards the data tab, and under data types, you should be able to find stocks. So just click on that. And just like so, you can see that we have all of these icons on the side. Double click up here so it resizes a bit. What we wanna do is let's first select the Apple one here, this icon, click on it. And you can see that we get a ton of information ranging from the price to the currency and the description for the company. Now, in order to fill in all of these lines next to it, first we'll select all of them. So Control Shift down. And you can see this plus sign over here. So that's what we wanna click on. From here, the first thing we want is the industry. So we're just gonna click on it. And just like so, we're gonna get all that information. Then we also want the price, so we're just gonna go on that dropdown again and try to find the price from here. It should be towards the bottom, like so. Same thing with the market cap, which is basically the number of shares outstanding times the price. Click on that. And lastly, for the PE ratio, this is a useful ratio for people that are typically looking to invest. So let's click on that one. And just like so, we have all of the information we wanted in real time from the internet. Now to analyze this data, let's first convert it into a table. So we're just gonna Control A and hit Control T. Hit OK there, that's gonna convert it to a table for us. Just hit Not Now for that. And you can actually go ahead and remove all the table style if you want, just to hit Clear there. That's gonna remove it for us. So let's suppose that we're interested only in companies that are in the software space. So to filter for that, we can just right click and go to Filter. Filter by selected cells value. That's the one we're looking for. So click on that. Now you can see we only have all of the software companies that maybe we want to invest in. Similarly, just press Control Z to go back there. Let's suppose that we only want those that have a PE greater than 25. To do so, we just need to go towards this dropdown, click on it, and under number filters, let's say we want greater than 25. And just hit OK there. Just like so, we have that analysis done as well. Awesome. Now moving on to step two, which is creating a simple stock portfolio. So over here, you can see that we have all of the stocks that we currently own, so those that we've invested in, alongside the price that we bought them at back in the day, and the quantity, so the number of shares that we bought. Now we basically want to know if we're making any money of these. So is the live price greater than the price we bought it at? If so, we're probably making money. So first, let's go ahead and select all of the stocks. So Control Shift down. Then we want to find out the live price, which is the current price. So just click on the plus sign again and hit on price, and we're going to find it there. And so we want to calculate all of the portfolio value here. So the total cost for us is simply the price we bought it at. So this one multiplied by the number of shares that we bought. Similarly, for total value, that's going to be the live price times the quantity. So quantity times the live price. And finally, the gain or the loss is simply going to be the total value minus the total cost, and hit enter there. Now to drag these down, just go shift right, shift down arrow, and hit Control D. Great. And really, you can start to see here that it's primarily been quite bad for us. All of these investments haven't gone too well other than one. Now to try to identify that a bit better and make it stand out, we can select all of them and then go to conditional formatting. From here, if it's less than zero, then we want to highlight it in red, as that's obviously not good. So highlight cell rules. We're going to go to less than zero. We want that to be in red, like so. That makes sense to us. So hit OK. That's how you would make a simple portfolio where you can see how your investments have gone, whether you made any money off them, and they're gonna stand out, especially if they're negative. And thank you to NordPass for sponsoring this video. If you ever find yourself stuck at work, waiting for others to give you a password, NordPass could be the perfect solution for you. They provide a secure way to store passwords and share them seamlessly with your team. And through their autofill feature, you won't be wasting any more time typing or looking for passwords. Also, with their user-friendly interface, you can easily add or remove passwords, users, and more. Finally, they also offer tools like a custom password generator so you don't waste time, and a password health checker to make sure your company's confidential information is safe. So if you want to keep your business efficient and secure, check out NordPass Business with a 3-month free trial using code KenjiExplains. The link for that will be in the description below. Again, that's a 3-month free trial with the code and the link in the description below. All right, back to the video. Lastly, what if we want to see the overall trend of a stock? Maybe we decided to buy Google, but we were split between Google and ExxonMobil. So we really wanted to find out if Google was actually the right investment instead of investing in ExxonMobil. Now to do so, we can use the stock history formula. And over here, you can see that we have the bought one. So we bought Google exactly 1 month ago, say, and we didn't buy ExxonMobil, that's their ticker, 1 month ago as well. So with the stock history formula, it's gonna allow us to go back in time and see the price trend. So for it, we're just gonna go equals stock history, hit the tab key there, and the stock for us that we're interested in is Google, comma, the start date is basically how far back do we wanna go. In this case, it's back 1 month. So to do that, we're gonna actually use another formula, which is the e-date formula. Hit the e-date, hit the tab key, and the start date is actually today minus 1 month, right? So we're gonna go equals today, hit the tab key. If you close those brackets, that's gonna be today's date, comma, and this is the number of months. So in this case, we wanna go backwards. So minus 1 month, and we'll select the one from here. Close those brackets, comma key, and the end date is when it finishes. So we want it to finish today as we still hold that stock, say. So hit today, close the brackets, and now simply close the brackets again and hit enter. And there you go. Just like that, we have all of the data from a month ago all the way to today. Same thing with the ExxonMobil. So we're simply gonna copy the whole formula. So Control C and Control V. If we look inside of it, just to make sure, you can see that it's now selecting ExxonMobil. That being said, in table format, it's not very easy to actually tell if it's done well or not. So instead, we're gonna chart this out. So let's select all of the data here, so Control A. And we're also gonna keep pressing the Control key so we can still select other data. And we're gonna select all of the close prices over here, like so. Once you have all of this selected, we're gonna go to Insert. Under recommended charts, we can find the line chart, hit OK. Let me move this around a bit, but the problem is that we don't actually need such a big range. So let's select it, right click, and go to format axis towards the bottom there. And here for the minimum, we really don't need it to be that low. Let's say we put a minimum of 80, hit enter. And now we can really start to see there's a bit of a trend here. But we need to rename these so we know which one is what. So just click on this one, right click, go to select data. For this first one, go on edit. And you can see that it's currently selecting all of the values here. So this one must be for Google. So for the series name, we're simply gonna click on Google there and hit enter. Hit okay there. So we have one that's Google, and so the other one has to be ExxonMobil. So under close here, we'll go to edit and change that one, the series name there, to XOM, and hit enter. Hit okay there, and now you can see that we have the overall trend, and it looks like ExxonMobil was actually a lot better of an investment, and we actually missed out on it. And what's really cool here is that the way we set up the formula, it's fully dynamic. So if I go ahead and change this to a 2-month period, that's gonna all change like so. Similarly, if I go ahead and change this to Apple, say, as that was the company that I was actually considering, you can see that all of that is gonna change the price changes, and so it's all dynamic there. To build a budget tracker on Excel, see this video over here, or this link over here if you wanna learn all about finance and valuation. Hit the like and that subscribe, and I'll catch you in the next one.